同学们好，很高兴又和大家见面了，我是 Coco 老师。今天我们学习绘画的是企鹅的假期。Hello everyone, good to see you guys again. Today, what we're going to learn is the penguin's holiday. 画之前先构图，确定三个企鹅的站位。Before we start drawing, sketch the whole picture. Make sure the three penguins position first. 半圆形画最前面的企鹅，也最大。Semicircle, draw half portrait of the penguin, which is in front, and be the biggest one. 把它画在画面的下半部。Draw it on the lower part of the paper. 我们现在在左边画一只正在滑冰的小女孩企鹅。We're now going to draw a girl penguin who is skating in the middle. 椭圆形的身体，因为离我们远一点，所以小一点。Oval body, as far away from us, she's a little bit small. 这里再画一个侧面的小企鹅，因为它距离我们最远。根据近大远小的原则，我们把它画得最小。Draw another one here, as he the farthest penguin from us will. We draw him the smallest, according to the foreshortening effects. 这次在右下角给它画个小尾巴。This time, give him a little tail.At the red bottom of the end. 从小企鹅的最顶端开始向下画一个 S 型的线，到尾巴尖结束。From the very top of the penguin, we curve down an S line ending at the tail point. After making sure how many and how big the penguin we're going to draw and where we put them, we now can go to the details.离开半圆形的顶部，留有一点距离。等等，我们要给这个小企鹅戴个帽子，画一个左弧线，一直往右延伸，再画一个右弧线，并将它们连接起来。Leave some space for the hair and the hat, which we will draw later. We draw a C curve line across the middle and the backward C curve on right. Connect them together.两个小眼睛 ,two little eyes, 喙四边形也像两个连在一起的三角形 ,big, diamond shape, also like two triangles connecting one line. 帽子微微向下画弧线，从这条弧线的左顶点开始向上画一条 S 型的线。Hat, curve down a little bit.And we draw an S line start from the left point of the curve line. 从这条 S 型的线的底端往回画，还是 S 型的线，一直到之前画的帽子弧线的右边的边缘。And from the end of S line here, we draw back, still using the S line, to do the red point of the hat edge. 帽子的顶尖再画一个圆形的毛球。Draw a fluffy ball at the end of the hat. 围巾。在脸的下面画两条弧线，距离稍微宽一点。Scarf, let's draw two curved lines, leaving a little bit wider space in between. 从弧线的右顶点向上画 S. From the red point curve up, draw an S line. 相同的角度再画一条。Draw the same S line again at the same angle. 再画一条。One more.椭圆形的小肚皮 ，his wide oval belly。现在画上小翅膀 ，now I'm gonna to draw the flippers. We curved down and curve back. 另外一边也是一样的 ，we do the same thing on the other side. 我们使用格子线表现出小企鹅身体上黑色的坚硬的羽毛。Here, we could use grid lines to show out a hard black feather of penguin. 现在画另外一只小企鹅。Now goes to other one. 在椭圆的上半部靠右边一点，我们画两条一样的斜线。We draw two diagonal lines at the same angle on right of upper half of the oval body. 现在在右边斜线的上面画弧线，然后是左边画弧线，用一样的方法。And draw curved line goes up and down on the right, and then do the same thing on the left. 画条小裙子，在椭圆的中间画条弧线。Let's give a little skirt for this penguin. In the middle of oval, we draw curved lines again. 我们先画一条，然后将脸部的线延伸至这里。We draw one curved line first, and then extend the face line ending to this curved line. 一样的方法，两个三角形画出小企鹅的嘴。Using the same way to draw the beak, connecting two triangles.双弧线，双波浪线 ，double curved lines and double waved lines。继续延长脸的线到肚子 ，extending the face line to the belly. We pretend here has the line but covered by the skirt.眼睛。再画上眼睫毛 ，eyes and eyelashes， 粉色的蝴蝶结 ，pink bow， 小翅膀 ，flippers， 长方形和椭圆形画出小靴子，像我们之前学过的画袜子的方法。Rectangle and oval combines her boots, like we learned how to draw the socks before. 在靴子的底下，先画两条直线。然后在靴子前面开始画旋线，旋线一直沿着靴子的底端画，直到超出脚后跟再停笔，但要离开一点距离。We're gonna to draw a spiral line goes along the bottom of the boot until exceeds its heel, but leaving a distance. 这只小企鹅的黑羽毛，我们用直线来表现。Here we're using another way, straight lines to decorate the little penguin. 还是双弧线画出围巾 ，double curved line again to draw the scarf for the penguin。但要注意的是，围巾要围在小翅膀的上面。But do please remember we draw the scarf above the penguin's flippers。因为这只小企鹅是侧面，我们看到的嘴是三角形，也只看到一只眼睛。As this penguin we draw is a side portrait, we draw the big triangle shape and only one eye could be seen. 现在在小企鹅的头顶画两个垒起来的长方形，下面的大一点，上面的小一点，然后连接两个向下的弧线，在顶点处画一个圆形的毛球，就画成了小企鹅的帽子了。Now I'm going to draw the two rectangles on top of the penguin's head. Make the bottom one bigger, the next one smaller. Then draw two upside-down C-curve lines and a fluffy ball at the end of a point. We draw the head of the little penguin. 使用相同的方法画出冰刀鞋。Using the same way, we draw his ice ski boots. 这次使用虚线画出黑色的羽毛。This time, I'll use a dashed line to demonstrate its black feather. Tusala, coloring, which is my favorite part.这样就画好了。这节课我们使用了大量的线条而代替了平涂的方法，画出你喜欢的小企鹅。希望你能够点击和订阅我的频道，我们一起学绘画。 This is all for today. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe my channel and we'll see you next lesson. Bye!